I honestly never seen an episode involving elderly who know Miley Stewart for so many years fight against each other because of the past. And, jeez, I've seen stuff like this so many times, and I just think that it's starting to become more common that we pretty much know of what's going to happen towards the end of the day and the end of the situation that they have to deal with. So Aunt Dolly is going to be part of the awards show that Miley Stewart is hosting as Hannah Montana. And of course, her grandma isn't approved of this because of the past. However, with the feud that Dolly and Miley's grandmother had because of the boy named Dolly in the high school, that the relationship that they had with the boy, it got really, 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 really ugly. And that was probably 40 or 50 years ago, considering the fact that though they have gotten older to the point that they just can't move on with their lives. Yes, I've seen this before, and it was in the perfect pair from the My Little Pony episode. And I can see that this is going to be way more different because they keep going on even to this day since they meet each other on some occasions since they met Miley Stewart at her house several times. Miley Stewart isn't going to accept Aunt Dolly or her grandmother's arguing because this night is extremely important. They did a demonstration by disguising them as Aunt Dolly and Lily as Grandma and Jackson as Elvis, and they tried to show of that they need to get along and move on from their differences. It really goes to show that she really wants to do everything that she can to not have this night ruined for her, because this is really important since this is an award show. Now, they did get along, however, at the award show. My god, the embarrassment has just begun. During the award ceremony, in the speech that Miley is just trying to give, Aunt Dolly and her grandmother start a brawl, or what Miley says, a granny smackdown. I think that's what she pronounced it, which is a reference from a WWE Smackdown or something, or the Rock catchphrase. By the way, if you actually expect me to review an episode from The Rock, keep this in mind. I don't need to review all the episodes that I consider way more famous. I just only need to focus on the episode that has the most attention. Besides, the episodes of each season has a lot. Almost up to 30 from seasons 1 through 3, except for season 4. I'm just letting you know. Just letting you know. Anyway, after the night, Molly isn't going to accept Aunt Dolly or her grandmother whatsoever because of the disaster that just happened. However, Miley is afraid that she might be able to use both Aunt Dolly and Grandma because it's basically something that she still enjoyed meeting her grandmother and Aunt Dolly during the times in her life. And I think that's probably the most acceptable thing that she wants from the two women that support her during her family life. Which I really think that this is probably one of the reasons why I think that people love Grandma and Aunt Dolly in this show. I can really see this cliche of seeing Aunt Dolly and Miley's grandmother arguing because they usually have a huge problem that they had in high school, but at the same time, it was like 40 years ago. And I can really see that they probably wanted to have something to do with Aunt Dolly and Miley's grandmother to have a competition against each other, because from what I heard, these two are really popular actresses. I'm sorry, I don't know a lot about these two actresses. Just please don't judge me. I'm just pointing out my opinions on these two characters in general. I mean, the award show that Miley really wants to do during her life as a pop star really is really important to her, but what happened between Aunt Dolly and the grandmother, it got really out of hand to the point that it almost became hilarious, especially when Lily said while in Miley's home to tell Jackson that you've been watching wrestling and she should change to the channel where the award show is going on. And then Jackson says, this is the award show, which is actually kind of humorous. And I actually kind of enjoyed the moment from Jackson for the most. But for what I mean is that I think that this cliche that they did by having two ladies not getting along because of the past differences, you can tell that this episode is just doing the benefit of the doubt by having two actresses just having some kind of a competition with each other, kind of like Miley Miley Stewart did against the Jonas Brothers in the Jonas episode that I revealed last in the last Hannah Montana episode that I revealed. And yes, I can't get over the episode titles, The Too Long. There is a subplot where Rico's just trying to show that Rico's place is the place to be while on the beach, but at the same time, he's camera shy, so he has to find replacements for other people who can do a much more better job in front of the camera. And at the end of this subplot, Rico just completely edited his voice in someone else's voice, and it will probably work out really easier. So it's basically Rico's voice that he's having a problem in front of camera, while his face is also being the exposure of what he's just trying to do. Yeah, I really got nothing else to say because this subplot has Oliver and Rico together in a subplot. That's basically it. And I really think that this subplot is just basically having Oliver to do something while Jackson is just trying to help Miley to have Aunt Dolly and her grandmother get over the differences. I just got nothing else to say about the subplot because it's better than Jackson and Rico's subplots, but you can't just even question about Rico's decision on just trying his best to make this video really important for his stand on the beach. Even Oliver just doesn't understand why Rico is just being Rico, even when he's respectful to Oliver. Even though that's completely a difference in the season 3 episode that I was about to review, but I had to change the thoughts. I Will Loathe You is something that I think that it kind of works if you are really curious to see two elderly who have a terrible history and also having a bit of rivalry. But unlike in The Perfect Pair, at least I can understand that these characters have a backstory and a reasoning to fight against each other. And the brawl that they had at the awards show is probably the most funniest thing I've ever seen. Well, when it comes to award shows, gain some embarrassments. Anyway, I'm Lonely Fanboy for you, and that's all the season 2 episodes I review for Man Montana. I give this episode a 7.5 out of 10, and then next is season 3 episodes. I'm halfway there.